I want to mention another grammar, which is complex and interesting and also not helpful. So the most cited academic of all time is Noam Chomsky. He's a linguist at MIT, has been at MIT for many, many years. And as a young man, he wrote an article which demolished behaviorism, you know, half a century or a century of psychology in one article. And this is what the article was about. It was a review of B.F. Skinner, the great psychologist, the great behaviorist psychologist, a review of his most recent, quite a late book in his career, a book called Language. And Skinner's argument was that, you know, everything you learn from behaviors, and verbal behavior is something which you learn purely from the social environment around you, because as a young baby, you're immersed in conversations and language and people and who are speaking, and as part of that process, you pick up language. So his argument was, it's the behaviors around you, behaviorism, which produces language. And what Chomsky said in one article is, he said, look, this is impossible. Language is so complicated and so huge, it's just not possible to learn language that quickly. It must be there in the brain already. Chomsky invented a grammar which tried to interpret the structure of thinking from the structure of language. So above what happens in a sentence, there are a set of logical connections between verbs and nouns, and which reflect intrinsic ways of thinking. And here's one of a simple map in this diagram. And in the next diagram, there's another map of how these underlying structures appear in language. What did Chomsky's theory say about culture and learning then? Well, first thing he said was that the language must be hardwired into the brain. It's impossible for something so huge and so complex and with such logical intricacy. It's not just the fact that a child learns a few thousand words by the age of, you know, 4 or 5 or something or other, but also the logical connections between those words are extraordinarily subtle and complex. So therefore, it must be hardwired into the brain. And Chomsky even used the phrase, the language organ. There's some bit of your brain somewhere which is a language organ, and you are born with that, such that when you start hearing Japanese or German or English, it always fits into the same structures which are already there. It's just a matter of filling the slots with words, filling the logical slots with words. And one of the consequences of this theory, though, is that in the Chomsky view of things, the deep structures of language are always the same. In other words, no matter who you are in the world, no matter what language you speak, underneath it is actually the same, if you like, universal language that everybody speaks. Now, one of the criticisms of this is that it does erase a lot of cultural differences. Isn't it the case that if you're speaking one language or another, that your way of thinking is somewhat different because the language is different? It's not that everybody thinks the same way. And the most interesting cases, by the way, in this direction are languages which are isolates, which are languages which are not part of isolates are languages which have no direct relatives that are close by them. And in Europe, example of those languages might be Basque or Finnish, which are not Indo-European languages. But in the world of indigenous languages, for example, in Australia or in South America or Canada or the United States, there are profound differences between these languages. And in fact, some of the great linguists, Benjamin Lee Whorf and Sapir, they went looking at these indigenous languages and said, look, people think in these incredibly different ways, and the language is a sign of those different ways of thinking. One other thing about the Chomsky grammar as well, too, is that Chomsky never pretended that it was of any educational use. So in a way, it's a very formal language system. It's never really been implied in educational settings. There's nothing actually that you can really do with it. And one of the problems of this idea of there being a language organ then is if there is differences in students' linguistic and cognitive capacities. But don't forget, for Chomsky, language is not just about language itself, it's about underlying patterns of cognition. If there are differences, they're in the, and they're in the language organ, there's not much you can do about it. So it actually doesn't have much of an active role for education at all.